We're in Hasongo. Hasongo has been taken over by Nagas after it has been damaged by Eothus, apparently. We've just taken over the cannon rampart, and let's see if there's anyone alive in there. And what we can do with this cannon. There's also these barrels here. And in some of them are even cave walls.
Hey there.
Yeah, also, somehow it didn't work out with the arquebus, so... I'm just putting Frostseeker in here again. Let's see. Yeah, that seems a little bit more fun, right?
I'm here. Yes. Yes.
Oh yeah. Also, we could take this that we want to level up to. 145 out of 150. We need to do it. Come on, get the grublings down.
They'll hurt yet.
Not gonna go for some spells with this. That would be madness. Boom. Sweet, sweet. Let's remove the barrels first.
I'm here.
Another cave worm.
Very well.
Cave grubbling. Whatever.
Yes.
I guess it will be the end of it. A caustic backlash. So what did the snakes have? Again, the coral naga swords. Reptilian eyes, reptilian bloods. Need to find out about this. A coral naga bow. Very exotic, but only fine. See what else we can find out. Yeah, a lot of these bows. What can we do with a cannon now? Let's see. A heavy brass bombard is perched atop the wall, pointing out to sea. From here, you have a commanding view of the flooded fortress. Scan it. Broken towers rise feebly from the water, and corpses and debris float between them. You see no sign of life until you note movement near the center of the fort. A large cluster of Naga has congregated on the central walkway. Yeah, turn the bombard toward the cluster of Naga. You try, but it's stuck. Looking down, you notice the gears attached to the rotating platform are rusted. We'll push it into position. Come on, you can do it. Pushes, but it... hardly moves, okay. How about Kilbasa? Not really, okay. Adonan. Not really. Wow. No one, actually. Christine. Step back from it. Bombard continues its lonely vigil. Check for ammunition. Bombard itself is not loaded and you don't see any ammunition for it nearby. I'll leave it alone. Which means they stole the ammunition, probably. Something's wrong here. Let's get down into this and explore. What is below the cannon ramparts? Find out very, very soon.
Yes? They don't see me coming.
I'll have someone was killed here.
I shall.
Oh, there's a lot. There's even a Naga soul here. So we can maybe find out. There's a couple of Naga warriors here. You know what? It's time for you. Time to die.
What can I do?
What can we do? Well, we'll buff up a bit.
What's up? There's something you don't see every day.
Yes.
Okay, Vava. Yeah, we can just stand here. Same goes for Lord Paul. Steen will just do her things. Buff up. Create a doppelganger. Dire blessings there. Whoa, there's an archer even. I didn't see the archer. Well then. Gotta be funky. No. Are you coming now, Naga? Or what? Oh, they can spit?
What is it?
Oh well. I guess it's time.
With pleasure.
Let's get pawed.
Yes.
Christine, what's their weakness? It's electricity. We don't have electricity. Doesn't matter. We'll go for the freezing pillar. That will explode everything around here. And that's gonna be F-U-N. Fun. Buff it up. Devotions, and now.
I need something sharper.
That was going quite nicely, right?
So much for you, well.
Bah. Just too crazy. Now let's just shoot this. Shoot this out of existence. Down and out. Mm-hmm. What have we found here? Fine leather armor. The artillerist's manual. When taking aim, the artillerist must account for both the distance of the target and the velocity of the wind. What follows is a series of diagrams specifying the ideal firing aim angles for targets at various ranges. Ooh. See. Need to lubricate the bombard.
I'll see it done.
The crates smell musty. Peering inside, you see they're full of black powder.
I got this. Keep an eye out.
What's it with these guys? There's nothing special about this. And here. Debris charred and blackened with spent gunpowder. Whoa, wait.
Yeah?
Need a mechanics expert for this. Kelvasa, you're on. Gunpowder, cannon shots.
Hey there.
Things like that. And there's more in this. Fine arquebus. Something is blocked in here. How can we get there? Can we get there from the other side somehow? It seems like we can't. For some reason, this is definitely blocked. We'll see if we can somehow get to it from another side. Or from an underwater entrance. There's something here. Wait, there is something. What is it with this thing? An entire section of the wall has been smashed, leaving a chasm of jagged rubble below. Broken planks and battlements jut from the opposite side of the break. We'll throw a grappling hook over. Securely catches the parapet. Cross the rope. You shimmy to the other side of the wall. Nice, now we're here. And we can go down into this, and maybe we can reach it then. We'll see what's behind there, what's down there. Let's find out. Ooh, whatever this is. Seems to be some kind of old kitchen. I think we just found a lubricant or something. The stairs descend into a flooded hallway. The water is clear and the passage seems to continue for quite a ways. We'll swim into the passage. The passage begins to grow dim and the water cloudy, reaches an intersection where the walls are spiderwebbed with cracks. The hall continues to the left and to the right. The way on the left is dark. There's a faint glow to your right, but still dark shapes obstruct the passage. Orient yourself at the passage. Your finely honed sense of direction tells you that the hall to the right leads west, while the route to the left seems to bend southeast back toward the docks. Southeast back toward the docks, and the hall to the right leads west. I mean, we want to go to the docks, right? The hallway curves around until you reach a door. It's swollen with water and stuck in place. You give it a cursory tug, but it will take more effort to pull open. Use the pry bar. Wedge the pry bar into the door jamb, and bracing your feet against the ceiling, push all your weight into it. The door pops open, revealing stairs to the surface. You swim up. We should have reached... Yeah, that's exactly where we wanted to go. Hello, Naga soul. You feel the presence of a soul, twisting and sinuous. It notices you too and draws nearer. Its restless essence tingles against your own. It is searching, hunting. You recognize it as the soul of a Naga.
What is this? Come closer. You glow so brightly. Just like the
soul recoils from a memory of violence, like a child snatching her hand from a hot stove. What were you searching for?
A way.
Memory blooms at her core. A burst of vehemence shudders through her essence.
The striped fiends profane the island, endlessly burrowing, building. They bury the Adra under stone. Sugan says we must find a way in. Sugan says I must find a way in.
There's warmth in this thought. Pride. Who is Sugan? Maybe we could talk to her.
Speaker for the gods. Grandfather to many. He leads us here. And here I must find a way in. The fiends gather at the walls, searching too. Not for me, but they see me still.
I feel a prickle of sympathetic pain, as if pierced by a volley of bullets. You died.
No, not dead. Still searching.
A desperate dissonant ripple thrums through the Naga soul.
Stay a little longer. Your glow is a comfort here.
What are you looking for now?
A way, I said. A glowing, shining way.
As she speaks, you feel yourself pulled into a memory and into the dark abyss of the in-between. You remember it from your own brief sojourn there. Yet from the darkness, you and Yanas see a bright rift, a pillar with roots that seem to reach into the heart of the world. You recognize this as an Ardra pillar.
The way glows like an anglerfish lure, but it feels safe.
It does. You are drawn to it. We'll drift toward it.
I will follow the way, I think. But then I see another glowing thing. This one does not feel safe.
Another glowing figure appears, this one shaped like an enormous walker. Three stars burn above its brow. You feel Yanas fear this walker thing, even as you recognize it as Eothas. Draw back. You watch as the glowing figure approaches the pillar. It reaches out and the violent current rips through the darkness. You hear a chorus of screams, but they sound distant and distorted, as if coming from underwater. Light and energy flow into the strange being from the pillar and from 100 points gathered around it. At last the pillar is dark. The glowing walker recedes brighter than before. Everything is dark.
Now, there is no way. And no light. I am afraid.
Then come with me.
You who amble and wander. I feel it in you. You drift through life like flotsam on the tides. I cannot lose my way.
I'll restore the Ardra pillar, then you can continue on your way.
I am searching for a way. Show me.
She melts into the ether and becomes a quiet presence beside you. So we freed her. There's also something hidden there. And we'll see what we can do further about this strange invasion and Eothas in the next episode. Have a great time until then at Happy Gaming. This is Immanuel Kahn. Signing out. See you soon, my friends, and happy gaming.